Today we are going to read this beautiful statue depicting an elegant queen and a pharaoh Menkaure, the owner of one of the three super famous Egyptian pyramids. Hi everyone and welcome back to Exploring Art with Alessandro. In the previous video we started to know more about ancient Egyptian art and today I want to talk about a statue with unique features, King Menkaure or Mycerinus and Queen. Apparently it seems something easy to read, right? There is a pharaoh, a woman holding him because maybe got mad at somebody, but I'm going to show you that there is a lot to know, so leave your comments and tell me your opinions. The nearly life-size statue depicts a simple scene, the pharaoh Menkaure and a queen standing side by side on a square base and supported by a shared black pillar. But beside the scene itself, we are impressed by the serene ethereal beauty and regality of the two figures, amplified by the use of the dark stone polished to look smooth as silk. But let's make a step back to start our story. On January 1910, excavators uncovered an astonishing collection of statuary in the Valley Temple connected to the Pyramid of Menkaure. The pyramids have always been the main excavation site, basically ignoring the Valley Temple. That was a big luck since the valley was full of finds, and among them, this statue dated back between 2490 and 2472 BC. And this dyad of King Menkaure Queen is breathtakingly singular. They both face to the front as convention, but Menkaure's head is slightly unusually turned to his right. A theory is that the statue was originally positioned within a niche, making it appear like if they were walking outside it, and the head would have helped to suggest the movement. The king is depicted with a broad-shouldered youthful body covered only with a traditional kilt, the pharaonic headdress Nemes on his head and a fake royal beard. The king's arms go straight along his body and he's holding the ritual cloth rolls in his hands, amplifying the idea of a strong, statuary young man. The static position is broken by the stride forward with their left feet. There, since both are in the same position.
For us, that couldn't seem a big deal, but if this action was entirely expected from the king, it's unusual for the females, since they were mostly depicted with parallel feet. That's a useful hint, and the surprises are not over yet.
The queen, sensuously modeled with a proportioned body emphasized by a clinging dress, stands at nearly equal height with the king, and she's holding him in a protective gesture. The reason is that probably we are looking at the king's queen mother rather than one of Menkaure's wives. Unfortunately, who is the queen is still a mystery since the base of the statue, which is usually inscribed with the names and titles of the subject represented, was left unfinished. We are sure about Menkaure's identity because he resembles other statues from the same find spot bearing his name. But beside the identities, looking at the statue will feel the royal elegance, and it's fascinating because we cannot really read the emotions on their faces, but just an inscrutable peace that brings to the eternity. A last couple of fun facts. Unusual for a pharaoh's image, the king has no protective cobra perched on his brow. This notable absence led to the suggestion that both king's Nemes and queen's wig were originally covered in precious metal, and the cobra was part of that addition. Moreover, even if we think that this dark material is super cool and fancy, it was actually brightly painted. There are in fact traces of red around the king's ears and mouth and yellow on the queen's face. This brings to an interesting suggestion. Since the statue was located in a courtyard, it's possible that the paint, used to make the figures look real, may have been intended to wear away over time, revealing the immortal dark stone.
As you can see, even something that could look boring hides a lot of surprises, and there are still many things to know about this ancient population. In the next episode, for example, we are going to learn more about a famous Book of the Dead, so don't miss it. Ciao!